basically, in this textbook, there are three Yoko models. The first is the basic Yoko model. The second is the economic production model. The third is the Yoko with discount. But since it's a basic class, I will just introduce the basic Yoko model. So you may ask, when will we meet this kind of problem? So imagine you are a manager in a manufacturing factory. So you know the demand of one material over 1 year. Then one of the questions will arise naturally. How much should I order each time? And how often should I order? So basically, EOQ model answer these questions. So EOQ is just to find out fixed ordering size such that the total cost over 1 year is minimized. So basically, when we talk about total cost, you will think about how many parts does total cost consist of. So naturally, you will think first maybe the cost of purchasing the product. But here, in this EOQ model, we have some assumptions. The first assumption is we don't have quantity discount. It means no matter how much you order each time, you always get the same price. And the other assumption is you know the demand of that product over the year. So it means no matter each time you order how much, over this year you have to pay a fixed number for purchasing this product. So in the EOQ model, you don't discuss the purchasing cost. Then we have two kinds of cost in this model. One is the carrying cost, holding cost, or inventory cost, whatever you want to call it. The other one is the ordering cost. I will talk about the ordering cost first. So in this model, we have sample S to denote the ordering cost. So ordering cost is kind of insensitive with the quantity you order each time. We can think of as the ordering cost as the documentation preparing cost or some legal fee. So usually it doesn't change with the order quantity. So for this kind of, for the ordering cost, you want to know how many orders you have to pay during 1 year. So since we know the demand of that product during the year, and you know the quantity each order you will purchase. So if you use D divided by Q, you will know the number of orders you have to place during that year. Then we use this times S. This is the total ordering cost during that year. So this is the one part. The other part I mentioned is the holding cost. So in this model, we have some assumptions, such that the demand rate is distributed evenly during that year. So it means you know during this year, I need, for example, 365 tons of one material. Then it means each day I need one ton. So in this model, if I draw a picture to represent the inventory, you will see the x-axis represents the date, the time. The y-axis represents the inventory. So in this model, we assume at the beginning of the period, we receive Q product, unit of product. Then since the demand rate is constant, then the inventory reduced in a linear way. We have assumption that we know the lead time, and the lead time does not change. And since we know the demand rate, so when we find out the inventory on hand just can satisfy the demand during the lead time, then we should place an order, such that when the inventory reaches zero, we go to another order of Q. So imagine during 1 year, we will have cycles. So each cycle, at the beginning of the cycle, we have the inventory of plenty of Q. At the end of the cycle, we have inventory zero. So for the inventory cost, here we use H. H is the per unit, per year holding cost. then we have to use h times the average inventory. Through this year, we have many cycles. For each cycle, we know the average quantity is 2 over q. Actually, it's q plus 0 times divided by 2. So also, q over 2 is the average inventory through the whole year. So for the holding cost, it's h times half q. So we want to minimize the total cost. So actually, the total cost is this, the sum of these two parts. And it's easy to see, if we increase q, it means each order we trace more, then we will have fewer of number of orders, then the ordering cost will decrease. But since we have more q, then the average inventory will increase. So actually, we try to balance between these two costs. So one way is to take the derivative with q to Tc, then we can solve, then let it equal to zero, then we find out the value, the square root.